Adam Vinatieri misses a massive extra point. Massive extra point. I got a lot of people telling me, oh, you going to make excuses for him? No. He hit that ball fat. It was an ugly kick in a massive situation. Not something that Adam Vinatieri does, by the way. Last week, I explained to people the field goal operation. Hey, the laces, unbeknownst to a lot of people who are diehard football fans, are actually on the long snapper. Yes, I know you saw Jim Carrey play in a comedic movie. Yes, I know that you learned about Finkel, Einhorn, and Marino. Yes, I know you learned about death threats that happened, and Dan Marino was blamed for the laces out. And that has become the national narrative, because in high school football, that is the expectation. In college football, that is the expectation, that the operation isn't as honed in. But nowadays in the NFL, with long snappers making millions
and millions
of dollars, they are judged on their lace placement. That's just the way it is. 1.25 operation, that's what the snapper's job is. The holder's job is to put the ball down on the spot, get the proper lean, and fix the laces if there needs to be a little bit of adjusting. And then the kicker's job is obviously to make a kick. Yesterday on that extra point, perfect operation. Vinatieri hit it fat and missed it. Although he made two field goals earlier in the game. We'll forget about those. Let's talk about the extra point that was missed. Everybody's talking, is it time for Vinatieri to hang it up? I talked to Vinatieri earlier in the year, whenever Stephen Holder alluded to Vinatieri saying that he was going to retire, and then the internet went a buzz, and Vinatieri doesn't have an iPhone, so he was on that plane ride home. Didn't even know that the world was talking about him retiring until he landed, I think. He just so happened to have like three text messages from me, like basically tell, hey, you're the man. Don't worry about any of this. And he wakes up right out of his slumber, right off the plane. Ding, 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 ding. His phone's going off. Oh, the world wants me to retire. I talked to him that night and he said, I said, how much longer do you think you're going to do it? You know, because this is a moment that we had together. I didn't ask him if he was going to retire because I had to go and get up the next morning and I had an open microphone and I don't trust myself with the filter enough. I don't trust myself to know things and just like be able to just turn it off. I think people know that about me too. Like my friends and family, they know that like, hey, there's probably a good chance if Pat hears something, he's going to say it. I mean, that's just the way it goes. And I think that's why our show does well. I think that's potentially why our show does. Hey, you want to talk about humans being unfiltered? I'm pretty much unfiltered. Aside from these damn FCC rules that can cost us a lot of money, and I like to look out for my people. So I asked Vinny, I said, how much longer are you going to go for? I don't want to know if you're going to retire. I mean, that's your world, not mine, and I don't even know if you've even thought about it, but how much longer are you going to go for? He said, I've always said, and this is true, as long as I can help my team, I'll continue to kick. As soon as I start hurting my team, I'll be done with it. A lot of people right now are saying Vinatieri's hurting his team. Yesterday is an indication of that. Could have a younger Vinatieri made that kick last week in Heinz Field, which is notoriously the hardest place to kick, kicking into the open end, which is notoriously the hardest place to kick into, with the laces straight back. A younger Vinny, could he have made it? I would assume so. Greatest kicker of all time. Could he have missed it, though, as a younger kicker? I assume so. Greatest kicker of all time. I think Justin Tucker, that's why the Wolf Pack over there with Justin Tucker is so impressive. Morgan Cox, Sam Cook, and Justin Tucker, because it's an operation. Now, Justin Tucker gets a lot of credit, as he should, because he hits the purest ball I've seen in a long, long time. But that operation is very clean. It's like whenever Vinatieri hit like 40-some straight, and we have the NFL record for it. Overton was snapping perfectly. I mean, all I had to do was just sit there, put the ball down, and get the hell out of the way. It's an entire operational thing. So does Vinny feel that today, I wonder? I don't know. Last night, I sent him a motivational text. I got one back. He was bummed. I haven't heard a text like this from Vinny, I don't think, ever. So I'll be excited to see how that all plays out. I'm not going to tell him to do anything, though, by the way. He's earned the right to do whatever the hell he wants to do. I think that's how Ballard and Frank Reich are looking at it, too. So let's say the Colts make it to the playoffs, and you have a game-winning kick, and you had Vinatieri on your team, and he leaves, gets forced out, whatever it is, and you bring in another guy, and that guy just all over himself. What are you going to do? You're going to be like, well, we had the guy. We had the guy that would notoriously step up and make this. Are those days behind him? I don't know. But this is it. Let's just assume in the kicking world, though, whenever you think you're just going to go find one, that's just going to be a plug-and-place operation. That's not the way it goes, by the way. That's not the next guy that could potentially, or lady. I don't know, honestly, what's out there. I have no idea. The next guy or lady that comes in and kicks for the Colts, if the Colts do move on from Vinny and Vinny decides to move on or whatever it is, I'm not saying this is going to happen, but if it happens, that person could be just as bad as Ty Schmidt at kicking field goals.
Yeah.
You have no clue what this person's going to do. It took the Steelers a few guys whenever Swedgham got hurt,
yep.
Scobie came in. Even notable guys, notorious guys. Nugent was up there for the New England Patriots for a little bit. It's hard to find a kicker nowadays. They are not in abundance. Yeah, you see guys kicking on Instagram and stuff like that. Those are only the makes. And I'm saying that because I did that whenever I was training for the Bears. I didn't put any of misses up there. You're not going to see any guys put up misses on things. So is there a chance that there's a better kicker out there than Vinatieri? Maybe on the internet, the guy's better than Vinatieri. But it's hard to just say, hey, this guy's had a rough season. He's missed some kicks he has. Last week, I'm not putting 100% of the blame on him because it was the entire operation. Luke Rhodes, the snapper, even came out and said that. I'm not putting the blame on just Luke Rhodes or Rigoberto. I think they bounced back perfectly, especially in something that revolves around, you know, what are small inches?
Millimeters.
Centimeters.
Yeah, those things. And milliseconds as well. Whenever things are that quick, it's easy to kind of paralysis by analysis, not be able to bounce back. The ability and wherewithal by Luke Rhodes and Rigoberto to bounce back after sending back a laces straight back on a game winner. By the way, that is what he has to think about too, the long snapper. Like, you guys could all come after me for explaining the operation, but the long snapper, that could have been something that could have gotten in his mind. It didn't. He bounced back. But Vinny missing kicks is not good for Vinny. It's not good for anybody. It's not good for the Colts. He knows that. I'll be excited to see what happens. We'll be right back.